with enough talent to make this team a contender because he's that good of a quarterback. Larry, the floor is yours.
Hey, I appreciate that, Andy, man. I want to make sure that you understand me, man. I never take for granted the opportunity to get in here and speak what I feel, man. And that's what a lot of people don't really get, man. It's just an opinion, man. I don't give a damn if you like it or not. You're entitled to yours. I'm entitled to mine. And I say all of that to say this. All these people keep saying that we're going to waste Deshaun's career if we're going through a rebuild or whatever. This isn't necessarily a rebuild when you have a quarterback. If you want to say that the next 3 years are going to be hard, let me tell you how old Deshaun is going to be when those next 3 years. He's going to be 27 or 28.
Yep.
I would still take my chances with a 27-year-old Deshaun Watson when I'm watching Tom Brady play till he's 45. You do not make this kind of deal if you are not trying to do damage to your franchise. And as far as the draft picks, we got through this season without the draft picks for Larry Tonsil. We'll get through this 21 draft with the picks that we have, and then everything falls in place. This isn't that complicated. The only issue that we're having over there on Kirby is that Deshaun Watson does not like the fact that he was lied to. And what I was always told is if your ass lied to somebody, you might want to try to make up for it and apologize and maybe not do that again. If they get rid of Jack Easterby over there in that locker room, and I think Cal McNair has to go get him some therapy, I think his ass will be okay because he's being lied to by a lot of people over there that is untrustworthy. There's no reason on this earth that Andre Ware, Andre Johnson, Deshaun Watson, all these other dudes are going to do anything to the Texans when they've been loyal to the Texans from day one. They're more loyal to the Texans than Jack Easterby. And if he was a man, a chaplain, or whatever that he's not, which all he is a con, his ass would step down for the betterment of the T-E-A-M. That's what we all know. So this isn't that complicated, man. The Texans can get right. Because if you're going to bank on Casario being as smart as he is, free agency is where you got to go make your move. Resign Will Fuller. You already got a left tackle. You got a quarterback. Get rid of Whitney Merciless and Hargroves and all them dudes over there and go get somebody that can play on that defense. I'm okay with them keeping Deshaun Watson because I'm telling you, it has taken us way too long to get into a position to have a guy like that. And we do not have enough time in our lifetime to sit up here and watch these those silly-ass dudes struggle to get back to the point we are now. Last thing, Indy, I saw you last night on Channel 2, and you was talking about Cully. I want to make sure everybody understand me. I'm not opposed to Cully. He wasn't my choice. I understand the game that they're trying to play by having him over there and maybe being able to manipulate him. But if you're David Cully, the one thing you should be doing today, your ass better get on the phone with Deshaun and say, man, meet me at Papa Do's on 16 and let's do this thing and I'll holler.
I'm 100% with you. I hate all this trade talk. My thought is the Texans need to figure out a way to keep them happy. That's part of the business.
And that was the one thing I said we're seeing David Culley on Friday. It's like, man, I want him to just, like, show I'm here. This is my thing. Let's go. Instead of the, oh, thank you so much to the McNairs. Oh, you know, like, come on, man. Talk about, let's go. This is what I'm doing. We're turning this thing around.
And I just want him to.